In this tutorial, you will learn the method of creating cast members and animating multiple objects. For that purpose, the first cast member will be created by selecting the filled ellipse tool from the tools palette. Select your tool and create a filled ellipse in the stage window. Select the final frame, 30th frame, and the position of the object when it is in the 30th frame. Second method of creating a cast member is through the paint window. So from the window menu, select the paint option. This will open up the paint window for you. Select the ellipse tool. Change the foreground color if you want and draw the object in the paint window. As soon as you draw the object in the paint window, this member is automatically added in the cast window. Come back to the stage. Select the object and add the object in the second channel by dragging, keeping the left mouse button, and let us start this object from the 15th frame. This means when our first object will animate from frame number 1 to frame number 15, at that time only object 1 will be visible. Object 2 will be visible when the first object reaches its 15th frame. Decide the position of the second object in the stage window. And let us take it to 45th frame and decide the position in the 45th frame. Third method of creating a cast member is from the window menu, select the vector shape option. This will open the vector shape window. Select a tool and draw the object of your choice. As soon as you draw the object, an entry for the object is added in the cast window. Come back to the stage window. Select the third object that you have created. Another thing that you must notice is that in the cast window, you have created three kind of objects. First is a shape object that was created from the tools palette. Second is a bitmap, that is a raster window that was created using paint window. And third one is a vector shape that you have created using vector shaped window. In order to place this third object in the stage, another option that we have is we can drag and place the object directly in the score window and let us start from frame number 45, or you can drag and begin it from anywhere, or we can start from frame number 30 also. Decide the initial position of the object on the screen and the final position, how it is going to appear when it is in the, suppose, 60th frame. Once you are done, come back to the first frame to see how your animation will run. That's it.